Hey, what's up guys? Welcome back. You're watching for today. So finally, highly customizable ROM Rising OS started to roll out their new update, Rising OS 7.0 Persis. So all maintainers of Rising OS team releasing their official update for official devices. I have given the list of officially supported devices and Rising OS official Telegram group in the video description. So you will get the regular details of this ROM and their upcoming updates. But you also got this customizable, which I booted on my two devices. One is OnePlus 9RT and another one is Poco X2. So if your device is not in the list and if it's too old, you can still use such GSable, and if they are working well on your device, then you can try them as a daily drivable build. So please check video given in Icard for detailed installation and testing of custom GSable on any device running with Android 11 and above version, with ARM64AB system, with unlocked bootloader and treble support. Today in this video, we are thoroughly going to check all the new changes and amazing add-ons of this update. We also discuss some of its bugs and the issues for OnePlus 9RT and Poco X2, which may occur in other devices also. So all official and unofficial device users and custom GSI users will get thorough idea how this build is. So watch this video till the end. Now without further delay, let's get started. If you want detailed review of all the features of Rising OS, then please check our old video review given in iCard. First, we'll see the new changes of about device details of this build. ROM has unique about device details with rounded cards and touch animation. This is the Android 15 build with the Rising OS version 7.0. Codename is Persis. This is Lineage OS 22 based custom ROM. Security patches of this build is of May 2025. For 9RT, this GSI have same stock kernel version 5.4.254, which is built with the LVM toolchain 11. Build date of this ROM is of 17th May 2025. If we check the same details of the GSI on Poco X2 or Redmi K30, everything is same, only kernel version is 4.14.350, which is built with the Clang toolchain 17. Except that other things will remain same for all devices running with the GSI. It's a great thing that custom GSI builds are giving regular security patches with new updates. Now let's check out the new changes of this build. In the personalized section under the gestures, we got some new gesture activities. We can change the swipe back gesture arrow style to simple one and new one by using this toggle. We get the new 3-finger long press gesture, which will give lots of possibilities to open different shortcuts application by using this gesture activity. Along with this, we can also use older 3-finger long swipe gesture, which also can be used for lots of different shortcuts. So by using both of these gesture features, you can improve productivity of your device. Along with this, we also got the shake gesture, which is already available from the last build, but that time it's not so smooth and not so responsive like this one. Now it is immediately activates your defined shortcut by just small shake gesture, which can be controlled using the sensitivity slider control. In toolbox and the extra option, we get this RAM boost toggle, which adds ZRAM in the kernel, which will help to expand RAM capacity, but it will be more useful if you get the actual size control for ZRAM here. Smart power off option helps to set power off timing for your device, so you can power off your device automatically, especially during sleep time. In the toolbox, team has added the new backup and restore option for personalization setting. Who gets the option like backup personalization setting, who can upload them to drive, who can download and restore these backups again whenever we switch from new ROM to Rising OS. This is only useful to take backup of personalization options of your device. Now in the spoofing option of the toolbox setting, we got this new spoofing guide, which have GitHub notes for how to use these all spoofing features. But when I tried this none of page have any guidelines. Maybe this will be available soon on GitHub page after few days. Next in the sound and vibration, we got this new vibration and haptic setting, which will help to control vibration haptic feedback for different settings like back gesture, brightness slider control, edge scrolling haptic, QS fling, QS ties, slider control of the settings, etc. In same setting, we get this clear calling option, which will help to reduce background noise during calls. Even we get the dedicated option to change charging sounds of your device. In widget setting, ROM now have added some of the new widgets like family space. This one is just a widget to quickly access camera application by just one click. Rising OS Altus launcher widgets have some different quick shortcut widgets like Bluetooth, data, device battery, photos, and Wi-Fi toggle widgets. But Wi-Fi and the data toggle widgets are not working properly, except that other widgets are working well. Last but one of the newest feature added by the Rising OS team is a new quick multi-window bar in the status bar. While using any application, if you tap on this bar, it gives the three different options like to open currently running application in multi-window. Another one is to open application in split screen mode. And other one is to open application as a full screen. This is pretty useful feature to expand capabilities of multitasking in Rising OS. But there should be some setting team has to implement in this ROM to control this multi-window bar, because I didn't found any setting for customization of this feature, and it's very big in the status bar, which looks ugly. So we've seen all important features of the new Rising OS update, and this ROM is pretty stable on both of my devices with minor bugs. It has almost all the things working on both of my devices along with all the sensor. And DRM info is also showing as L1. So we can stream Netflix or Amazon Prime like application with the full HD resolution in this ROM for any device. So I will only show you what bugs of this ROM I found for OnePlus 9RT and Poco X2. On OnePlus 9RT, alert slider is not working. All play integrity checks are failing in my OnePlus 9RT. Even though I tried safety net spoofing feature available in this ROM. While in Poco X2, only basic integrity check got passed. So you may face issues while using some banking and security applications. Fingerprint setting is not available in both of my devices, but face unlock is available and working good. Issue of 4G calling still persists in both of devices like old GSI builds. These bugs may vary for different devices on this GSI, while custom ROM users will not face any kind of issues. This is all about for today, guys. Hope you got idea how new Rising OS 7.0 is and what are its new amazing features. If you like our work, then please do like and share this video, subscribe to our channel, press the bell icon for notifications of our upcoming related content for review of custom ROMs and Android mods. Thanks for watching. See you next time. Take care. Bye-bye.